regionally, it's absolutely devastating. Everything would be killed.
It seems that these days, most people know about the Yellowstone supervolcano. But very few people know that, beginning about 35 million years ago, and continuing for about 10 million years, Colorado was devastated by a series of enormous volcanic eruptions rivaling anything produced by the Yellowstone supervolcano. One of them, which produced the enormous La Garita caldera, may very well have been the largest volcanic eruption in the last 450 million years. To illustrate just how huge La Garita was, let's look at three well-known supervolcanic eruptions. The largest of the Yellowstone supervolcano eruptions produced about 2,500 cubic kilometers of ash. The Toba eruption of 74,000 years ago, which produced the Lake Toba caldera, produced about 2,800 cubic kilometers of ash. La Garita produced 5,000 cubic kilometers of ash. The geology of Colorado and New Mexico is quite complex, and at present there is a great deal that simply is not known about the origins of the massive volcanism during the Oligocene epoch and its relation to the formation of the Rio Grande Rift. But my purpose here is to explain current thinking about the volcanism and tie it into Western North American geologic history in general. Let's go back 75 million years to the late Cretaceous, when much of California and the Pacific Northwest was being assembled through the accretion of a series of microcontinents, or terrains. Western North America was beginning to override an oceanic plate called the Farallon Plate. The massive collision of tectonic plates compressed and thrust upward the western edge of North America. The compression, folding, and faulting of interior rocks combined with erosion through time created the southern Rocky Mountains. By the middle of the Eocene, about 50 million years ago, southwestern North America had begun overriding the East Pacific Rise. The compressional forces that had formerly held sway in the southwest gave way to tensional stresses as the crust thinned and stretched. This created the Basin and Range province throughout Nevada, and to the east, where the rocks were more highly deformed and much thicker, it created the Rio Grande Rift. Beneath the thin crust of the Rio Grande Rift, magma, rising from the mantle, pooled and formed a magma chamber. Following zones of weakness, it eventually reached the surface to create a series of volcanoes. A rising plume of superheated mantle material eventually formed a gigantic magma chamber beneath the volcanic center. Eventually, the pressure of the rising mantle material became too great. The crust gave way in a devastating supervolcanic eruption. As the magma chamber was evacuated, overlying crust collapsed into the void, creating an enormous basin called a caldera. Over approximately the next 10 million years, this process was repeated, and at least 10 caldera-forming eruptions took place. The largest of these was the La Garita eruption, approximately 27.5 million years ago. The last of the great caldera-forming eruptions was about 26 million years ago. After that time, the nature of volcanism in the area fundamentally shifted from explosive eruptions to lava flows. Perhaps you're wondering about the climatic effects of such massive volcanism. Although it's impossible at this great distance in time to perfectly correlate the volcanic activity with climate, it is worth noting that the Oligocene, shown here in yellow, was generally a period of cooling, and the first Antarctic ice sheets appeared at this time. The beginnings of the Oligocene were an unsettled time environmentally. A number of things were happening, including the onset of massive volcanism in Colorado. There was also a large bolide impact in Chesapeake Bay. and the onset of volcanism in Ethiopia that led to the deposition of massive flood basalts over the next perhaps million years. The beginning of the Oligocene also is marked by one of the great extinction events in Earth's history. Many groups became extinct, including brontotheres like the one shown here. Over many millions of years, the deep mantle plume source for magma that created conditions for explosive eruptions in this part of Colorado seems to have dissipated. The reason is unclear. Buried deep beneath the surface is a large magmatic body that is now too cool and too dense to rise to the surface. Explosive caldera-forming eruptions in the Rio Grande Rift did not end with the cessation of such events in Colorado. 160 kilometers to the south lies the Valles Caldera. And the Valles Caldera was formed about 1.1 million years ago when a catastrophic eruption pumped out about 250 cubic kilometers of ash. The Valles Caldera is not the earliest caldera formed at this location. It, in fact, destroyed and largely obscured an earlier caldera, the Toledo, which 1.5 million years ago pumped out about 400 cubic kilometers of ash. It's unknown if the Toledo caldera itself destroyed earlier caldera. In any case, this volcano system is regarded as dormant, not extinct. Okay then, that ends part two of our series on supervolcanoes. And per the request of the viewer, there will be no Ann Coulter at the end of this one to scare the living shit out of you. Only me talking about next time. Next time, we'll be looking at the Long Valley Caldera in California. After that, we'll move farther afield to New Zealand. Auf Wiedersehen und Lebwohl.